हेलो फ्रेंड्स, फाइनली वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स। इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स इंट्रोडक्शन मीनिंग। इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स सिंपली मीन्स पासिंग ऑन द बर्डन, पासिंग ऑन द बर्डन ऑफ टैक्सेशन टू अदर पर्सन। दिस पासिंग ऑन द बर्डन यू विल कम टू नो एज एंड व्हेन वी विल स्टडी इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स। बट डायरेक्ट टैक्स कैन बी विजिबल, द पिंच ऑफ मनी गोइंग आउट ऑफ योर पॉकेट कैन बी फेल्ट इन डायरेक्ट टैक्स। बट इन इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स द पिंच ऑफ मनी going out of your pocket is not felt because you don't come to know when you are paying such taxes. You pay indirect tax every day, every single day. Even a poor person has to pay indirect tax. If he go and buys a single 1 rupee hair oil, on that also he has to pay tax. That is indirect tax. He pays tax. He doesn't know he is paying, but he is paying indirect tax. But direct tax can be visible when you pay it, and it hurts your pocket. Because it goes out of your pocket. This also goes out of your pocket, but it is not directly told that you are paying the tax. If it is told you are directly paying the tax, you will feel the pinch. Many of the people are not aware of indirect tax. The common layman does not deal with indirect tax. We commerce students only know what indirect tax is and what direct tax is. This chart is a complete general knowledge. If you don't want to listen this part, you can skip it. But I want you all to write this chart and read it later because this is important. I'll be giving explanation what it is. This is a common sense general knowledge. You should know under which list which all items come. Okay, which all chapters do fall under which list. List 1 is the union list. Union list is a central government list. Governance is there of central government. Central government governance is there. See, I have written union list. List 2 is state list. State government governance is there. List 3, concurrent list. Both central government and state government governance is there. Okay. Under list 1, that is union list, which all chapter falls are income tax under entry number 82. This entry numbers are important because you should know the entry numbers. This is a general knowledge, you should know it. But let me little bit zoom out. Okay. Income tax under entry number 82, custom duty under entry number 83, excise duty under entry number 84, CST, that is central sales tax, under entry number 92A, service tax under entry number 92C, list 2, state list. State government governance is there. Under this, VAT under entry number 54, VAT is value added tax. State excise duty, this is central excise duty. Central excise duty, and this is state excise duty under entry number 51. Concurrent list, there is nothing. For our portion, there is nothing. I'll show you, just wait a second. See. This is the first page, basic concept of indirect tax. Here you can see union list, state list, concurrent list. Here the entry numbers are given to you all, but I have given a description of which all entry numbers, which all chapter has which particular entry number. So this is important. Please pause the video and copy this much. Please do this. I hope you all have copied, given ample time. The most important thing every students want, breakup of marks. Please don't pause the video right now and start copying it. Please listen to me what it is first. Central excise duty, maximum 4 marks. This I have made excluding options. Excluding options, okay? That means whichever sum you attempt, these are the maximum limit. And finally 52 marks, which will automatically, any of this will come for 3 marks or will come for 2 marks. So it will get adjusted. Okay. This is the maximum marks. Central excise duty, maximum 4 marks. So in regard of central excise duty, whatever we'll study is good enough for 4 marks. So this is an easy chapter. I want you all to write easy chapter, but you need to revise it properly. Custom duty is again an easy chapter. There is nothing huge to do in it. It is a easy chapter. 4 to 8 marks maximum. Okay. सेंट्रल सेल्स टैक्स इज अगेन एन इजी चैप्टर, बट हियर वी हैव टू स्टडी लेस, वेरी लेस वी हैव टू स्टडी, एंड फॉर दैट वी आर गेटिंग 4 marks, दैट इज मोर देन इनफ. वैल्यू एडेड टैक्स इज अगेन लिटिल लिटिल बिट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, बट स्टिल स्टिल ईजी. आई रिकमेंड इट एज ईजी, मैक्सिमम 4 marks इट विल कम फॉर. देन बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सर्विस टैक्स. Now service tax has started. We'll talk about service tax later. Before that, we'll talk about SenVat credit. See, here you can see VAT, and here also you can see VAT. Value added tax is also known as VAT. SenVat credit. This is not a chapter. This is a credit that you will come to know later when I'll be teaching SenVat credit. This is also a very easy chapter. Theory is only there, but very simple chapter. Maximum 4 marks it will come for. Now let's put light on service tax. Service tax, basic concept of service tax, we have to study negative list as well as mega exemption for basic concept of service tax, as well as definitions related to service tax that I'll be teaching. That is good enough for 4 marks. This part is easy. Point of taxation is the very easy part of entire indirect tax. Trust me, point of taxation, central excise duty, custom duty are the most simple thing, and you should never skip this part. Valuation of taxable service, this is little bit tricky, right? Tricky over here. Tricky. 4 to 8 marks. Exemptions and abatement, this is theory. Again, it is an important chapter, little bit tough. 4 to 8 marks, but we'll make it simple. Don't worry, I am here. Service tax procedure, it's simple, procedures are there. You have to just memorize all the procedure, what is the procedure of service tax, what we have to do to get service tax registration and all, that I'll be teaching you all. It is also an easy chapter, I'll make it easy for you all, so maximum 4 marks. So now I just want to tell you, even if you don't listen to my lectures henceforth, or you have already studied this all chapters, but you just want the breakup, that's why you are listening. So just now listen carefully. Never ever skip this 5th chapter, this 4th and the last one, because these are the most important chapters and you can score good marks over here. Because service tax is something, they might ask something critical, except point of taxation. Point of taxation is such an easy thing, many of the students leave point of taxation, I don't know why. So service tax excluding point of taxation, that is total comes to 28 marks. That means the remaining 21 marks you have to study, because this is very difficult. At times students read the question and don't understand what the question was. So never ever try to skip in this first four chapter and the last 5th chapter in point of taxation. If you want to skip any of the part like service tax procedure, you can skip it. Exemption and abatement, I will not recommend that to skip, but service tax procedure I can recommend, you can skip it for once. If you have less time to study before exam and you have not studied, you were ill and whatever the case is, but I recommend you have to study full if you want to get exemption. I'll make everything easy for you all, but for the students who are just listening for the breakup of the marks, please listen, don't ever mess with this chapter, because if you mess with this chapter and you go prepared for only service tax, then you are gonna fall in a huge problem. Okay, now please pause the video and copy. I hope you all have copied. I just want to tell you the schedule of how we'll continue. First we'll go with central excise duty, so one it is, right? Then we'll go with custom duty, then we'll go with central sales before going to central sales tax, we'll go on VAT. We'll complete VAT first, then central sales tax, then we'll move on to basics of taxation of service tax, then service taxation, then point of taxation, not this is 5, this is 6, then we'll see exemptions and abatements, then we'll see valuation of taxable service, 8, then we'll go on to service tax procedure 9, then we'll move on to SenVet credit. So this much is the procedure, how we'll go. This is the schedule. So I hope if you want, you can copy the schedule. That's it. Please pause the video and copy. I hope you all have copied.